Welcome to the Millard Auditorium for the Performing Arts. Please take a moment to silence your devices. In the unlikely event of an emergency, locate and proceed calmly to the nearest accessible exit. Comply with any official instructions. We would also like to remind you to enjoy refreshments in the outer lobby only. Thank you, and enjoy the performance.
$20 million, Pontevedro is done. Ladies and gentlemen, Intermission is over. Shall we dance the night away? With his mistress?
Which one?
Oh, niece, just tell me where he is.
At Shea Maxine's.
Alone?
With the ladies.
You mean the grisettes. I would hardly call them ladies.
I would disagree. They have their charms.
Well, is he on his way?
He was a bit indisposed.
You mean drunk? Great, the one man who can stand up for our country can't even stand up.
Well, I explained the urgency of the situation, and he promised he would make his way down here. Too sweet.
Thank you. She's here.
Hello. my friend. Be a chap and find me some whiskey.
Whiskey? Sir, I think... You know what? Never mind. I must tell Baron Popoff you're here.
No. Please. I haven't slept in days. The Grisettes. My very, very fatherland. Whatever will you understand? I'll sweat for you with all my might. But rather were my day than night. I'm sitting at my desk, my one. Although the urgent files galore, a little furtive drinking done. I'm back at home for drinks at four. Private interviews I'm closed, the weary statesman in his chair. But keep my mouth severely closed with diplomatic song of fair. I play my part without a doubt, though the results are somewhat thin. I use my entree as an art, and I subverse out and in. The strainer it is great indeed, until the day I see the light. No wonder that I sorely need a little change of scene and flight. I'm off to shame and seat, to join the world tree, for one brief enchanting moment, like romancing. Go, juju, go, bago, fufu, and when it comes to
gone now.
Why did you
He said he was in here. But all I find is the two of you.
We were looking for the widow.
Ah, Danilo, finally. I have a mission for you. It's top secret.
I am proud to serve my country. I would do anything.
You are to be married.
No, sir, not that.
The fatherland commands you.
And to whom does the fatherland need me to marry?
The widow, Anna Glavari.
Absolutely not. No way, no how.
But she must marry the Pontevedrian, where the country will go bankrupt when her taxes go to a foreign land.
Well, sir, I will have to find another Pontevedrian for her to marry, as it cannot be me.
Ladies' choice! Ladies' choice, gentlemen.
Ladies' choice, the ring of ladies' voice, some of them may hide you, man, the lights of the upper bed. One dances on alone, two over there you go. Supremely happy I would be if you would just kiss me.
Gentlemen, I am overwhelmed by your invitation. Gentlemen, I find I'm in an embarrassing position. I Yeah.
No, madame, I do not dance.
In fact, you don't care for the chance.
Don't care, oh no, my dancing told me so.
I did, what then?
The dance is mine, then, gentlemen. I can do what I like with it, as I think fit, and so.
What does he mean?
Charity.
10,000 francs!
hearts and minds. We must always be ready to support the fatherland, even in its darkest hour.
Darkest hour? Is Pontevedra in trouble?
Trouble? No. Everything is just splendid.
Oh, glad to hear it. Well, I hope you don't mind, but I have planned something quite Parisian for this evening's festivities. A surprise for Count Danilo.
Oh? Niche, did you know about the surprise?
Of course, Your Excellency.
Since Count Danilo is so taken with Shay Maxine's, I decided to rent out the entire place this evening and see what all the fuss is about. I even hired his beloved Risette for the entertainment.
I'm sure Danilo will be quite taken with this surprise.
And now, excuse me, gentlemen, but I must make sure no one is drowning at the lake. No worse way to spoil the party.
Where is Count Danilo? And do you really think it's a good idea for her to see him at Shay Maxine's?
Look, there he is, sir.
Where have you been, sir?
I was out all night. I haven't even been home yet.
You know Pontevedra has great need for your services. You must marry the widow Clavari. She seems quite fond of you, actually.
As I have said, I cannot marry the widow Clavari. I will, however, prevent her from being wooed by any amorous foreigner. Have any of those Frenchmen made any progress?
Yes, I've heard from a very reliable source that Camille de Rosillon is quite taken with her, and that she returns his affections.
Baron Popov, where did you hear such a thing?
Why, from my wife, Valenciennes. She says he only has eyes for the widow.
I'm not sure that...
So keep your eyes on him. Let's all go enjoy the party and meet back here at 6 o'clock to discuss our next move.
As you wish, sir!
I'll be here at 6 p.m. with bells on. What is this in my pocket? The fan. Forgot about this fine. I love you. Well, 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 the plot thickens. Excuse me, ladies. Did any of you lose this fan?
No.
Going for a swim, are you? Well, I didn't bring my suit, but perhaps.
What have you got there, Count? A new fashion accessory?
It's a fan with I love you written on it.
I hope for your sake, gentlemen, does not belong to any of your wives. This Count Danilo is quite the ladies' man.
I didn't write that on the fan. I just found the fan.
Can any woman be trusted?
My wife is the perfect model of fidelity. But it is impolite to brag. Women are the worst.
And the best. Ladies, wait for me.
What's the saying? Can't live with them, can't live without them.
Well, actually, you can!
We'll be right back.
might return it to its rightful.
Would you be angry if I should marry another man?
You should marry whoever you want.
Wonderful! Then I shall announce my engagement later tonight.
You're already engaged? It's been 2 days! You've done it again!
What do you mean?
When I left, I went to my uncle to beg him to change his mind and convince him that I must marry you.
You did?
Yes. And he relented. But by the time I returned to tell you, you are otherwise engaged.
Well, how was I to know? It was a long time ago.
Yes, it was ages ago. Maybe this time I will get to dance at your wedding.
Why don't you dance with me now? One last time.
Your husband pop off? Valencia, no!
I'll say no more!
Will you not let me?
Please marry Anna and forget me! This very night your offer must be spoken!
It shall be done, although my heart is broken!
Heart is broken too. I thought your love was.
going to come up with a secret plan, we need a secret place where no one will hear us telling secrets.
Yes, but I believe this space has already been occupied.
What do you mean? Who's in there? A woman? What's going on? Stand aside! It's Monsieur de Rosillon! With a woman! Niche, lock the back door so they can't escape.
What are we doing?
Shh! Monsieur Rosillon is in there! With a woman!
Who is she?
I don't know, her back is turned! They're kissing!
Can you see it?
They're turning around.
Oh my god!
What? What is it?
It's my wife! It can't be!
I'm sure you're mistaken.
He was kissing her! My Valenciennes! What shall I do?
All denouncers! Open up! Come outside! Right now! What? I thought it was... I could have sworn...
The lady that the time
you honor, who had sworn it was my wife, you know.
A modern wedding it will be. I promise, I promise, in a style emphatic. We have a little change of name. Instead of two, we'll have the same, just like a sister and a brother. And when the ceremony's gone, where every room may meet with one, you won't expect to find the honor.
In fact, you'll find it safe to state we are a pair, entirely up to date.
It's true.
My marriage will be one of great in the Parisian style. My name is all that will be changed in the Parisian style. And as we shan't be on the show, but for a little while, I'll go ahead and raise my smile in the Parisian style.
I'm off to that scene. I'm done with it.
she do that?
Why, for you, of course.
Anna, I mean Madame Blavary, what a splendid idea to have a party at Maxine's.
And what better place to celebrate my engagement to Monsieur Rosillon?
I need to speak with you.
Oh, so serious.
I forbid you to marry Monsieur de Rosillon.
Why?
Because...
Well, you will need a better reason than that.
He's French.
You're jealous.
Jealous? That's absurd.
Don't worry. I'm not really engaged. I was just having some fun at your expense.
Papa, my friend. Good news. She is not going to marry Monsieur de Rosillon. Her millions are still safe at Pontevedra.
Oh, thank goodness. Madame Bavaria, should you get engaged again, please, for the sake of the fatherland, choose a Pontevedrian.
But Baron, according to the terms of the will, if I remarry anyone, I forfeit my entire fortune.
You what?
Oh, we are doomed! Perhaps staying single is truly the best course of action.
You would have no money at all?
Not a penny.
I love you. I love you. Will you marry me?
You would have it without any money?
Of course. I've loved her since the moment I met her.
I accept. I would be honored to be your wife.
I'm very happy for the two of you, but madame, if you lose your fortune, Pontevedra will be bankrupt.
Not quite, Baron. You see, the will states that if I marry, I forfeit my entire fortune to my new husband.
Oh, thank God!
Well, penniless or filthy rich, I would still like to marry you.
My lips speak words unspoken, do you hear? What takes the
forgive me.